Earlier this week, it was reported that it was in fact FEMA, under Donald Trump's direction, that was the one stealing hospital supplies all over this country by intercepting or downright confiscating shipments of masks and ventilators and other personal protective equipment that hospitals had ordered. We didn't know at the time where this equipment was going, what was being done with it, or where it was being allocated, and neither did the hospitals. But as the week drug on, we found out more information. This entire scheme being pulled off by FEMA is part of a project called Project Airbridge. And what it is when FEMA steps in to help these hospitals order supplies or do things like that, they get 50% of it. So they just take their 50% off the top, they grab the supplies that they want, and whatever's left, if there's anything left, even though they're only supposed to take 50%, the hospital gets it. We have seen hospitals in New York. We have seen hospitals in Massachusetts make these large purchases with their money, by the way. And then FEMA steps in and says, hey, this is ours now. Thanks. We appreciate it. Maybe we'll give you some of the crumbs. Now we're learning even more than just that. We're also learning that apparently Jared friggin' Kushner is the guy in charge of allocating these supplies. And a couple of Democrats in the House of Representatives, they deserve to be named, U.S. Representative Benny Thompson and Carolyn Maloney, have actually stepped up and they have sent a letter to FEMA demanding to know what the hell Jared Kushner is doing being in charge of these decisions. Because they are rightfully concerned that Kushner is taking supplies from areas that need it the most, like New York, and sending it to states that don't necessarily need it because they're not experiencing the same shortages, like right here in the state of Florida. We're getting tons of equipment sent down here, even though we have not yet reported shortages of this equipment. We're getting 1 million doses of hydroxychloroquine sent to Florida, even though we don't necessarily need it. So supplies are being taken away from states like New York and Massachusetts and sent down here, and Michigan, and sent down here to places like Florida and Georgia. And gee, I wonder why that is. And these two members of Congress think they know exactly why. Jared Kushner, and this obviously makes sense, Jared Kushner is trying to reward states who praise Trump and punish states who haven't been nice to Trump. They're gambling with our lives. They're playing politics with our lives. And sure, yeah, that benefits greatly the people down here in the state of Florida. Meanwhile, roughly, what, 1,000 people a day are dying in New York right now? A lot of that due to the fact that they don't have the supplies that they ordered because FEMA is confiscating them, handing them to Jared Kushner and saying, here, Jared, do whatever the hell you want with it. Jared Kushner needs to be in prison. Jared Kushner absolutely should be questioned, should be detained, and not just about this. I mean, we all know some of the other things that this guy has been accused of. You know, where are those FBI investigations right now? But Jared Kushner should never, ever, ever, ever be in a position to be able to determine who gets to live and who gets to die. And unfortunately, if these two members of Congress are correct, that is exactly the position he's in right now. Jared Kushner is apparently a one-man death panel, just waiting to see who's going to praise Trump so he knows where to send all of his stockpiled medical equipment.